production is basically one of the best farming ideas that we can implement on our farms today, because of how people are interacting on the market, how healthy graph is changing. Everyone is trying to get something which is health, and fish is one of the best type of meat that you can get on the market, and it contains 3 fatty acids, which is not common in other meat in our meat industry. So basically, if you want to do fish farming and you want to make it successfully, you need to focus on these key things. For instance, the breed. You need to choose the best breed for your site, for your area. And in Zimbabwe, the most common type of breed we are doing is tilapia. These are breams. For instance, the red breasted bream, the biggest bream, the Nile tilapia. These are the most common type of that we keep in Zimbabwe. Why they are common in Zimbabwe is because they are warm water fish, which means they need warm water type. And this is very common in Zimbabwe because we experience hot summers, though our winters are experiencing cool temperatures, but they can still sustain in those periods because they are tolerant to such conditions. That type of breed needs to be good. Then from there, the biosecurity should be very, very good, right? So when I say biosecurity, we are talking about things around parasites and disease management. Fish is different from other animal or products, where you can put antibiotics, you can vaccinate your animals, which is different in fish. You can't vaccinate, you can't inject antibiotics, but need to be centered on biosecurity, making sure that there's a fence, there's a foot bath, there's a wheel bath, making sure that we don't have other parasites that is coming from other farms, especially those who are coming from natural water bodies can bring some of the diseases, right? That's biosecurity. Then come on to feed. Feeding is very key, because if you want to get 500 grams per fish within the space of 5 to 6 weeks, should be good. Our feed should be good. And how it will be good? It's through well formulated feeds with good protein content, energy content, so that the growth rate will be good. At the same time, increasing growth rate, our budget should not be strained in terms of feeding our fish. And we are saying we need to do feed formulation, or we can put manure in our fish pond so that will promote algae, since our fish are omnivorous, which means they consume both formulated feeds as well as green matter, right? Then from there, we have something called value addition. We are saying for you to get maximum revenue, you need to be involved in the value chain system. So after harvesting your fish, instead of selling it to other retailers, sell on your own. You can sell in your own butcheries or on your own backyard, either fresh packed or dried, then you pack, then you sell. Or you can actually separate the flesh from other material so that you sell only fresh. Or you can prepare your fish meal, then you sell to other retailers. In that case, you're getting more revenue. Thank you so much.